All right, everybody, I'm finally getting around to checking out Miley Cyrus' new album, Plastic Hearts, boys. I'm friggin' stoked, boys. Ready to get into it? I know you are. Let's do it. How you doing, everybody? It's Eddie over here. New for reactions coming at you some more. Miley Cyrus, boys. Miley Cyrus, all right. We're going to be going through the album, her new album, Friggin' Plastic Hearts, boys. All right. So, here's the thing. I already did videos for Prisoner, Zombie, and Midnight Sky. So, I'm going to be skipping over those. Now, the Prisoner one wasn't able to be on YouTube. So, that's available for free over on my Patreon. But the other two are on my YouTube channel. You can check those links. Maybe I'll link them up here. Or you can just check my channel later. Either way, boys. So, here's how we're going to do this. I broke down the remaining songs into two groups. So broke them into a group of seven and six. So the first seven songs on the album is what we're going to do here right now in this video. The remaining six are going to be exclusive content from my patrons over on Patreon, all right? Because I love my patrons. You guys are the ones who keep me going, keeping me doing this stuff. So I freaking love you. All right, so, but I got the first seven, whatever they are here. I don't know, whatever the first seven are. I don't know the names of all of them. But they're going to be here on the YouTubes, all right? So anyways, boys, if you love Miley Cyrus and you want to come along with me as I keep checking out more of her stuff and more kinds of pop music, you know what you got to do, boys? Become a friend. Mash the subscribe button, the bell notification, hang with me. All right, you ready to go? I know you are. Let's do it. Okay, WTF do I do? Okay, all right. WTF do I
I'm not trying to have another conversation. Probably not gonna wanna play me on your station. Pouring out a bottle full of my frustration. Here to tell you something that you don't know.
Okay.
I'm the type to drive a pickup through your mansion. I'm completely naked, but I'm making it fashion, baby.
Oh my god, she's starting off like a badass, boys. And in Miley fashion, she's starting off like a friggin' badass. She says, I'm the type of person that'll drive a car through your mansion. I'm the type of one that's naked, but I'll make it fashion. Miley friggin' Cyrus, boys. Okay.
Through your mansion, I'm completely naked, but I'm making it fashion. Maybe getting married just to cause a distraction. Here to tell you something that you don't know. Am I wrong that I moved on and I don't even miss you. Thought that it'd be you until I die, but I let go. What the fuck do I know?
Whoa. She's like, what is it? So I moved on, and is it because I couldn't be somebody's hero? Boy, who's she talking about? She broke up with somebody. She talking about her relationship with her ex. They broke up. They were married. They broke up. Hemsworth, was it? I think it was. Maybe that's who she's talking about. You guys can comment down below and let me know. But, okay, so she went through a breakup, and she's pretty much venting some of her rage with it. Okay, that's awesome. That's pretty awesome. She was gonna drop another hard beat drop there, boys. I'm loving the metal feel of this, boys. But based on the name of the song, it's, you know, any song with WTF in it, you know there's gonna be a lot of emotions, right? You knows it. And of course, boy, what a hard friggin' beat she got going there.
What the fuck do I know?
I like the drums.
See the stars through the new pollution. Think that I'm the problem, honey. I'm the solution.
Ooh.
Maybe all the chaos is for your amusement. Here to tell you something that you don't.
She delayed the beat drop. Now she's talking about, okay, you know what? We're gone our separate ways, but now I'm waking up with people. Different people, boys. Different people. Okay. All right. Well, you know, nothing wrong with it, boy. You broke up. Now it's time to get back in the swing of things if you want to. If you don't want to, you just want to love you, that's fine. If not, get out there, boy, and have some fun, right? Right. Nothing wrong with it.
Then I hate it and let you go. What the fuck do I know? I'm alone. Cause I couldn't be somebody's hero. You want an apology? Not from me. How'd you leave me with your misery? So tell me, baby, am I wrong that I moved on and I don't even miss you? Thought that it'd be
yeah, Dad is the chorus, boys. That's a friggin' hard chorus, and I'm loving it. I'm friggin' loving it. This is how she opens her album? This is a friggin' hard way to open. If this is what the album's gonna be like, oh my god, I'm not gonna be able to contain myself, because, boys, you know, I love Miley. I love Miley's voice. Loves everything about Miley. And here she is starting off with a friggin' rock song. And before I got into pop music, I only got into pop music a little over a year ago when I started this channel, but before that, it was all just rock, right? Rock and rap, but a lot of rock. And by when she starts rocking, by, I friggin' loves it. A banging beat, boys. Banging beat. I gotta pause it every at least every 30 seconds or something, but I'm doing the whole album here. By god, it'll block the whole works of it, and I won't be able to see a thing. Anyways, either way, whew, let's calm down a little bit. Do we need to calm down? No, we don't need to calm down. Frig that, let's go. That's how you open a friggin' album, boys. I'm just saying, that's how you open a friggin' album. Oh my god. WTF, boys. WTF, this is what the album's gonna be like? Oh my god. Okay, that's one of my favorite Miley songs I've ever heard. First time hearing it, and it's one of my favorite. It's just way too hard, way too bang, way too, like, get your blood pumping. Friggin' loves it, boys. All right, let's get on to the next one, boys. You ready? Oh my god, let's go. All right, everybody, Angels Like You, boys. Angels Like You. Let's go. Ooh, she didn't come in hard this time.
Flowers in hand, waiting for me. Every word in poetry. Won't call me by name, only baby. The more that you give, the less that I need. Everyone says I look happy.
The more that you give, the less that I need. This is like a sappy love song of some kind. Okay, okay, but still, that's fine. Just trying to figure out what's going on, but that's a powerful line there. The more that you give, the less that I need. It's almost like if somebody's trying to give you love, and you're like, the more love you're given, the less that I really need it. Wow.
Everyone says I look happy when it feels right. I know that you're wrong for me. Gonna wish we never.
She's saying she ruins everything. She brought somebody down to her knees. And okay, well, okay, this is different. This is like a breakup, but she's almost like she's taking responsibility for it. She's like, feels like she's responsible for it. This is the total opposite of the last one we just did, or the WTF one we started with, where she's like being like, this ain't my fault, screw you, whatever, I'm leaving now, whatever. And then this one, so is she talking about the same person, or is she talking about somebody else? Boys, who's this one about? Let's go.
And it's not your fault, I can't be what you need. Baby, angels like you can't fly down there with me.
Oh.
Not everything they said I would be. La, la, la. I'm everything they said I would be. I'll put you down so. Off your clothes, pretend that it's fine. A little more hurt won't kill.
my God, take off your clothes. Everything's fine. A little more hurt won't kill you this time, or something like that, she said. Okay, she's basically, all right. Yeah, because it's like, she's like, broke up with somebody or leaving someone, or has already left someone, but she still has some feelings for him, and it's like, well, maybe just one more time. Let's do it one more time, boss, you know. But anyways, and it was that other part she said over there about the angels, and she's like, an angel like you can't be down here with me. I'm everything that they say I would be. Oh my God. Oh my God. So that's basically saying she views the other person as somebody who was more like, you know, just more pure, more like an angel, and she's more of a badass punk rocker, whatever, or got weird fetishes. I don't know what the hell is going on with Miley, but what I'm getting on with is that she feels... yeah, that she's pulling the other person down. I don't know who the other person is, but either way, let's keep going.
Mama says you don't look happy. Close your eyes. I know that you're wrong for me. Gonna wish we never met on the day I leave. I brought you down to your knees. The least way.
That's the line. That's the most powerful line in the song so far. Is the angels like you can't fly down here with me. Angels like, that's the friggin' name of the song. I just noticed that. Oh my God. Anyways, I can see why. Yup. Me and Miley, boys, we got good brains. They thinks alike, boys. I think so.
Angels like you can't fly down here with me. I'm everything they said I would be.
Big buildup. I'm loving. That buildup was twice as long as I thought it would be. She held it for like 8 beats instead of 4 or something. Either way, friggin' awesome, boys. I don't know. But this whole song is totally different. Totally, totally different. We'll talk about it in a second. It's almost over. Touch to fade away the music at the end, just to sing with her voice. You know what I mean. Just her voice, not the music. Boys, what do we think of Miley Cyrus, Angels Like You? Friggin' emotional, boys. Friggin' emotional. And what is this? I'm feeling this is not about Hemsworth. I just get this feeling because you can't put out one song that's got a totally different approach of the relationship and how you left it, and then the next song be like, you know, you're an angel, I'm down here, you know, and still a sign of kind of feels like you still have some emotions or love for this other person. Maybe, possible, but I got a feeling it's about somebody else. If you knows who, comment down below, or if it is about Hemsworth, let me know. I don't know. You guys will know a lot more about Miley's personal life than I do. Either way, I'm just looking into music, and the music was friggin' banging, and I friggin' loved it. All right, let's get on to the next boys. Let's go. All right, everybody, now we got Miley Cyrus, Gimme What I Want, boys. Gimme What I Want, and I want some more friggin' Miley. Let's do it. Ooh. I'm liking that. God, what a grungy, sassy song this is, boys. Oh my God. Oh my God. All right, all right. This is how it's gonna be. You got the grungy, grindy beat, and she's getting on sassy. All right, let's do it. Oh my God. Okay. She's like, I don't need your future. I don't need your past. All I need right now is a friggin' lover. And if you don't give it to me, I'll just give it to myself. That's the way it is, boss. She's just got a craving, boss. She's got a friggin' craving to get it on. And she's either gonna get it on with you or somebody else. Or herself, she said. All right, let's go. She's like, you know what? She's like, I know as I'm with you, you're with me, I mean, and I'm your fantasy and all that kind of stuff. But just give yourself to me because I know that's why you're here and that's what you want is just to friggin' get it on, all right? So it's just like, relax. Let's get it on. Okay. What I need, and no one likes to be alone. No one likes to be alone. That's a catchy chorus, Buzz. Come on now. Come on, that's banging. And it's just cool and funky. It's just, this is a song, buddy, that people are gonna like. This is a Friday night song, Buzz. This is one when you're one of them young people and you're like, Buzz, I'm gonna hit the club, and you're getting ready to go to the club. What are you gonna put on? You're gonna put on this to get you in the mood, Buzz, get you all riled up, isn't it? Oh my. So give me a little- Nobody else. Why would you need anyone else? Woo! Loving that. Bring on the funk. Oh my God. Buzz, give me what I want, Buzz. What are we thinking, Buzz? Buzz, give me what I want. Friggin' funky, Buzz. Friggin' sensual again, Buzz. Friggin' sensual. That's what that one is. She's singing about all she wants to do at this point now is just get it on. She needs to get it on. She needs a lover. She needs to just, you know, have those feelings. But she's like, but you can be that one, and I know it's your fantasy and all that. Just control yourself. But either way, if you're not up to the task, then I'll just love myself. Oh my God, that's a song, boys. That's a song. Never heard nothing like that before. But either way, friggin' loving it. And I love the beat. I love the grunginess of it. It's friggin' hard. So far, the whole album friggin' rules. Let's get on to the next one. All right, everybody. We're on to Nightcrawlin' featuring Billy Idol, boys. Billy Idol teaming up with Miley? Doing a song called Nightcrawlin'? Let's do it. Crank it. Nice build up. Sometimes I'm good for nothing. Sometimes the best you ever had. Sometimes I need your loving. Sometimes I stab you in the back. I found the Boy, sometimes she needs her loving, sometimes she stabs him in the back. She sounded a bit batshit crazy, you ask me, but. she came in hard, boys. She came in was like a first. It was like a mix of between, you know, like almost like rock, but then it's also like that hard kind of synthesizer, funky kind of like 80s beat. Oh my God! All right. Oh yeah, 80s. Whoa, that's a lot of build. Now, what is, the lyrics are a bit confusing so far. They're a bit confusing so far. I'm paying attention, but it's just, they're a bit weird. She's talking about being on her disco ball, and then friggin', she loves somebody, she's stabbing the back, some other things, but she says she's night crawling, boss. She's friggin' night crawling. That can mean a couple things. Sometimes my oh. Alright, here we go.
Sometimes my thoughts are violent. Sometimes they bring me to the light. Sometimes I sit in silence.
His voice is awesome. How do you not love his voice? For frig's sake, that suits this song perfect. A song called Night Crawling, and the way his voice is very deep and kind of like, just kind of got that creepy little edge to it. I don't know. I like it. I like it, boys. Okay, I'll tell you one thing, though. Him and Miley in this song are sounding like they got, they got a bit of issues. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know whether they're trying to be good or trying to be bad. But either way, they're night crawling. This is a beat that suits both of these artists. Friggin' awesome. Wouldn't you agree? Especially Billy Idol. I don't know. This I can see why. If she originally made this beat and wrote these lyrics and stuff, and then she was just like, you know who'd be great on this? As soon as she heard that beat, he's like, that sounds like something Billy Idol will friggin' rule, right? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Just loving it. Oh yeah. Hold on. Those are like freaking keyboard drums, but it's like, that was a big thing, right? That was a big thing back in the day, was those keyboard drums. Either way, let's go. I'm loving that. That's what it sounds like to me anyways. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. That's how you do it, Billy. That's how you do it, Billy and... I was going to say Millie. Billy and Millie. Miley. It's Miley and Billy. But either way, boys, what are we doing at Nightcrawler? Friggin' awesome, boys. Friggin' awesome. Because it's a mix between, like, it goes hard with a bit of rock, but then it's also got that, like, 80s vibe to it. And it's got lots of build-up, and it's got a song that suits Billy perfect. Billy, I don't know, and Miley screaming in the background while Billy's singing too was friggin' amazing. Loved it, boys. Okay, that's this lyrics though. The lyrics, I don't know. You guys can explain this one. This one's a little bit more confusing to me, but it just seems like the two of them are like debating, like they're like debating whether to be good or bad, but it's like when the devil calls, we answer and we go out night crawling. So it's basically that, like, while, you know, you just feel at nighttime. I was like, "Well, so do you want to go to the party, boys? All right, boys, we're gonna hit the club, boys. We're gonna go get a little naughty, you know, a little naughty." That's what I'm thinking. That one's all about. Well, I don't know though. I don't know. You guys, let me know down below. All right, let's get on to the next one. All right, everybody, Miley Cyrus, Hate Me, boys. Hate Me, Miley Cyrus. All right. It's a short song. It's only 2 minutes long.
Go ahead, you can say it's my fault.
Oh, this beat is weird.
If it still hurts at all. I thought one of these days you might call.
Is it just me or is music weird? It's like the drum is doing an off beat to the rest of it and everything is like out of sync. It's weird. It's like not following a typical 4/4 beat for a song. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. I don't know.
Let's go. One of these days you might call when you were feeling small. Drowning in my thoughts, staring at the clock. And I know I'm not on your mind.
Oh. I know you're not thinking about me, but I wonder what would happen if I die. Well, I hope all my friends will go drink and get high. Okay, Miley. Okay, Miley. I heard what you said, Durr. I heard what you said, Durr. That's some deep emotional emo stuff. What's going on? Say, what if I die, then maybe on that day you won't hate me. If I die, then maybe. My God, is there people that hate her that much? But you know, maybe the only day that they won't hate her is the day that she dies. Okay. Oh wow. Okay. Dark, weird song. The song and the sound is so unique and different, but it's like the lyrics are way darker than the music portrays. Okay.
Just say it to my face.
Oh, say it to her face.
One drink and I'm back to that place. The memories won't fade.
Memories.
Drowning in my thoughts, staring at the clock. And I know I'm not on your mind.
She's saying the memories won't fade. And you know, I'm here just sitting here staring at the clock. And, you know I'm not on your mind, but it's like staring at the clock can be like, you know, mean multiple things, but maybe it just means she's like just ticking to watching time pass by until she dies, because she's already talking about what's it going to be like when she dies or whatever, and what other people are going to think of her. So, some dark lyrics here, Bonnie Smiley. Some dark lyrics.
And I know I'm not on your mind.
Talking about her friends, they'll probably just go drink and get high, but then everybody else will just be, you know, she's just hoping that it'll be enough that it'll make them cry. She got a lot of haters by, does she? A lot of people hating on her? Maybe. I don't know why. She's freaking awesome, but maybe just don't like her punk attitude. Who knows? Oh, she sounds.
I hope all of my friends get drunk and I.
She sounds a little different there.
Would it be too hard to say goodbye? I hope
Oh, she ends it with a build up again and just screaming, maybe down that one day, the one day that you won't hate me is the day that I die. Bias, oh my God, that's what Molly's saying there. All right, Bias, all right. That was the first, I think, 8 tracks or something, was it? I don't know, 7 or 8 tracks, and there's only like 5 left. All right, so let's just review these top ones here now. What do we think? Miley Cyrus, Hate Me. Well, that song in particular, Friggin' Hate Me, was pretty friggin' awesome. It was weird. The melody and the beat was weird. But then I started to get the vibe for it the more it went on. I think it's because the drum hits hard and it got 2 light beats and then it waits a second and hits a third one. I don't know. It was, caught me a little off guard, but either way, by the end of it, I got it. The chorus was super really catchy. That part brought it up. The song is very different. For those kind of lyrics, I would picture a different type of beat or melody to it. But either way, it's Miley. She's unique and original, and I freaking loves it. And that's what I think of that. Overall, the album so far, loves it. My favorite track, though, got to be the first one. The WTF something something something. The very first one on the album. That one comes in hard and catches you and just makes you friggin' want to rock out. So that's my favorite one so far. All right, bye. So, excuse me. The last couple, I think there's only 5 left. Those are going to be up on my Patreon. If you want to help support the channel, go on over there, sign up, get access to exclusive content. There'll be starting to put some exclusive content up there, like this kind of stuff. All right, I got to give love back to my patrons. They're the ones keeping me going here. I don't make a dime off YouTube. Well, I shouldn't say I don't make a dime, but I make pennies off of YouTube because 99% of these videos are copyright. And, you know, I'm putting 40, 60 hours a week into this. But anyways, I won't even get into that. It's the Patreons who are keeping me going. I freaking love you for it, all right? So anyways, comment down below. Let me know what you thought of the Miley Cyrus album. What's your favorite song on it overall? And so far, my favorite one is track 1. Anyways, if you got any enjoyment out of this video at all, be sure to hit the like button on the video. And that's it for now, guys. Peace and love, everybody. Peace. Catch you next one, all right? Take care. Bye-bye.